now that I've got a bit used to it, it's time to go just a little bit quicker. And these roads are fantastic, by the way. We're up in La Honda in Northern California. Sweeping turns, rolling hills, beautiful view, sunny day. Doesn't get much better than this. Man, that sounded like a bad commercial.
Welcome to Translogic. I'm Johnathon Buckley. We're pretty firmly on the electric motorcycle bandwagon, but every time we approach this topic, the same questions seem to arise. Battery life, performance, range, and price. Well, today, we seem to have found a company that have an answer to at least one of these questions.
The familiar whir of an electric motorcycle. It is something that I'm starting to get used to now that I've had the fortune to ride a few of these. Interesting to be sitting on an electric bike that is in fact the most powerful motorcycle that I've ever sat on. This is the part of the job that I absolutely love, because this is where the future lies. People have always said that there's a tipping point with motorcycles. Once they start winning races, that's when we're going to get mass adoption.
So I'm finally here in the office place, I should say, or the workshop of Lightning Motorcycles with Richard Hatfield, the founder and CEO. Tell us about this, the result of all of your hard work.
This is the Lightning LS-218, the fastest production motorcycle that you can buy and ride to work, and it's electric. There's been basically 10 years of development of electric motorcycles compared to 100 years of evolution of internal combustion engine bikes. So yep. I think we're at the beginning of where these could go.
Was it winning Pikes Peak that got it all the attention?
When we set land speed records, that created a momentum. When we won race championships, that was momentum. But the big goal we set and the biggest achievement was racing against the top cast bikes and winning.
Bonneville on the salt flats.
We went through the timing lights at 218 miles an hour.
That's incredible, 218 miles per hour from an electric motor.
Yes.
And just looking at the components, I mean, you've spared no expense. You've got all of the top stuff, Martensini rims, you've got Olin's suspension, Brembo brakes. I mean, you really have thrown the kitchen sink at this bike, haven't you?
We have, and it's, 40,000 is a lot, or 38,000 for a motorcycle. But again, this is a bike that a good rider could take to Pikes Peak or take to a racing event and win first overall.
Now, when we look at the LS218, we know that it was built for performance. But when I found out that this bike was pushing 200 horsepower at the wheel, that's not at the crank, that's at the wheel, and then around 170 foot-pounds of torque, I was actually getting surprisingly nervous. But what's it like as a street bike? And that's, I guess, why I'm out here testing it today. It's not super comfy. It doesn't have a super cushy seat. The suspension's kind of hard, but that's all completely forgivable just for the sensation that you get when you screw open the throttle. Full throttle! Oh, my God!
We all know weight is the enemy of the battery in today's world. How have you gone about bringing that weight down to, is it 495 pounds, which is, you know, comparable to anything else on the road right now?
It's been a lot of the focus is, you know, how do we use all the bodywork's carbon, the clip-on bars are carbon, the fasteners are titanium. So we've done finite element analysis on virtually every component and worked it down to the point where we could get the weight comparable.
Was there ever a thought of maybe making a bike that has an interchangeable battery pack?
We've looked at that, but it adds weight to the bike, 30, 40, 50 pounds. Yeah, so we're doing, everything we can to get the weight down. And right now it seems like a better choice, to charge the batteries quickly.
And let's do wheelie test now. Oh, no, there she goes. Oh, wow. That was half throttle. Starting to feel what the bike, might actually be capable of here. You turn the throttle and it just keeps pulling and pulling and pulling. You don't have to shut off to change gear. The torque stays the whole way through. It's something that takes a little bit of getting used to, but I like it.
In the pipeline, there is somewhat of a, let's call it a 600cc version of the LS-218
yes.
coming out for the everyman.
Yes.
Is that kind of like the Tesla model where we start out with a no holds bar, premium product with everything thrown at it, high price range, and then moving down from there?
It is, yeah. It's much easier to start at a high performance vehicle and work down into more mid performance vehicles. You know, I think this is the beginning of the level of adoption we're gonna see in a lot of other areas and in bikes. So, you know, when does it really take off? There's a lot of factors that play into that. You know, we're probably one of the few groups of people that wake up in the morning and say a small prayer that gasoline prices go up.
I love that this company, Lightning Motorcycles, they're actually playing with the big boys now. And the big boys are actually, I'd be surprised if they're not just a little bit nervous for what this means for motorcycling and the future of motorcycling. As I say that, my battery has just stopped working. All right, that's not cool. Oh, it's alive again. Interesting. I guess it just needed a reset. Kind of like when your iPhone freezes, I guess. That's exactly what just happened here. Let's see. So I've gone from having zero power. Oh, nope, it's alive again.
Unfortunately, this was just the first of a few technical issues that really cut down on our saddle time. But I guess some kinks are to be expected with a bike as ambitious as this. What I really loved about the ride was how you've somehow taken an absolute beast with some of the craziest numbers that are out there for a superbike, and you've made it accessible in the fact that it doesn't actually pull your arms out of the socket like I thought it was going to when I took off. Why is that?
So there is a lot of acceleration capable. I mean, you can get full power. You yeah. want it to be progressive and predictable. The more predictable it is, the faster you can go. So we've mapped the throttle. So 60% of the throttle movement is only 30% of the torque. And the last 40% of the throttle increases to full torque.
You've made it quite accessible for a lot of riders. For the guys that are perhaps a little bit intimidated, they're going to find this pretty easy to ride. For the guys that want to go blindingly fast, they're going to have a great time too. Well, we didn't get to do 218 miles an hour today, but that's not really the point. The point is that electric motorcycles are moving ahead in leaps and bounds, and now they're not only playing with, but they're winning against their gas-powered counterparts. We find that very exciting. Translogic, I'm Johnathon Buckley. We'll catch you next time.